Welcome back to Let's Play Torment, Tides of Numenera. I'm the RPG chick, now going down into the nethermost cavity of the bloom. Now that we emptied out all this, wouldn't call it water? Gunk? Bile? Disgusting stuff.
Of course.
Here we go. Now that you have entirely blocked the liquid that drained into the pool, you've revealed a human-sized hole at the bottom. A drumbeat like a colossal heart sounds from below, echoing through the gullet. The sides of the empty pool are slick and steep, descending to a gaping hole. You should be able to slime down the fleshy walls and into the chamber below. Oh. Why not use the rope we found, right? Tie the obedient rope to a bloom tube and use it to descend. This rope we found, actually in this level, that pretty much obeys your commands to some extent. Well, we lost the item. You command the rope to fasten itself to one of the hanging bloom tubes at the edge of the empty pool. I wonder if this gives us like some kind of advantage, otherwise, other than just blindly sliding down there. You grasp the rope and you can feel its texture adjusting itself to your hands, soft but firm, with fibers that grip your flesh. Your descent is quick, safe, and painless, though you have to let go of the rope to drop the last meter. Hope we're not going to need that rope for anything else. Dropping 1 meter shouldn't be a problem. Okay. Alright, looks like a pretty small area. This goes to the bloom heart. I hear something. Hello? Oh, fighting... Oh, you're fighting a... Navigate the valve doors to discover the entrance to the bloom's heart. Well, I already found it. An Abykos is fighting a Corpuscular Maw. I got different things we can interact with. We also talk with this tongue cluster. What if we interact with this? Oh, he's fighting two Corpuscular Maws. Or it's fighting.
Of course.
Of course. Bulbous venous sacs inflate with bursts of foul air, pulsing and jiggling in the humid, fetid breaths that emanate from the bloom's heart. The skin of the sacs is relatively thin. You might be able to puncture them with enough force, but it will probably draw the bloom's attention. Not sure if I want the bloom's attention. Why do we want to do this anyway? Yeah, I'm gonna leave it alone. Same here, I guess?
Naturally.
Can we talk to the Abykos? Hello? You recognize this weird angular being as an Abykos. It is probably the same one you released from the cyst in the vast interior. Oh yeah, he just like jumped off the edge after that. It seems to be hunting the scuttling maws. Based on what you've heard, Abykoses eat transdimensional energy, so it's probably trying to devour the rifts inside the little maws. Just leave it alone. I mean, should I be taking a side in this at all?
I'm ready. I'm always
ready. Yeah. It's half phased. Oh. Ah! Now it's attacking us. It wasn't me that hit you. Ah, oh, you idiot. Alright. It's on. You want to play hardball? I'm game. I forget completely what we have here. Is this a... What is this? Is this a cipher? Oop, character. I'm on myself. How about I use a sweeping glove? So what's this thing that we have? So guys, I'm just really curious. It's the Star's Kiss. Star's Kiss. Which we have... Oh, it's a weapon. Yeah, I'll use the sweeping glove. Just because we have to start using these ciphers. Does this mean he wants to talk? See, when this symbol, this blue, I don't know if it was quite the same. That'd be cool if we could talk to it. I mean, we've always just fought them. Or released from disgusting bio-filled sacks. So, when this blue thing appears on our character's portrait, that means it, that character wants... You know what, if it appears down here, that means that character wants to talk. So I'm wondering at this point if it wants to talk. Of course, first we're going to take care of this, these freaking things. I'm guessing it's Phil now, because it's half-phased, and it walked away. It's no longer fighting them. Right, so the glove of doom. Oh, I have to get closer.
I'm ready.
She's ready. Oh my. Something new is wrong with you? Is that you, Aretas? Oh, he's hobbled. Who's going now? Calistige? It's kind of pissed now, isn't it? Yeah, that's where the door is. Yeah, she can't yet.
Allow me.
She can travel great distances.
Come, taste your death.
Nice. Oh, we got randomly teleported. Oh, he's over here. Well, I couldn't see where he was. His grappling hook, sucker punch.
Barely making a
scratch. It's okay. So all you had to do is make a scratch. Do you want to talk now? This weird angular being looks. Oh, yeah. It shows no interest in you. Instead, it seems to be hunting the scuttling maws, though you're not sure why. I thought we knew why. Okay, I'm gonna leave it alone. Looks like we can just... This is a maze of some kind, obviously. You know, I want to talk to that tongue cluster. There's a tongue cluster, another one over here. Fully phased. Now what are you gonna do? Fight this thing?
Finally making a scratch.
Well, you didn't attack. Okay, it's just fighting him. You run over here and talk to this one. Well, whatever we're gonna do with it. The cluster of bloom tongues seems almost rigid, as if they had calcified or hollowed, but when you touch them, they soften and twist around your arms. You feel them tickling your mind, intruding into your memories like parasites. Allow them to feed on a memory, because every time that happens, we remember something, right? The curling tongues extrude filaments of psychic force into your body, mapping your nervous system. You twitch and spasm as they explore your neural pathways, and when they withdraw, you're not even sure what memory they've stolen. You just feel drained and empty. Alright, well, that requires an action. I'm guessing I can do this next time. Ow. Okay, Kalish Tease. Try to talk to this one, since it seems to be occupied with the Abykoses and vice versa. A cluster of bloom tongues shivers and quakes before you. At your touch, one of them writhes around your arm, and you feel its insistent, invasive, psychic touch in your mind. The bloom tongues call up your memories, drawing some of them to the fore, almost as if they were choosing a dish at a banquet. I'll allow it. The bloom tongues thrust themselves deep into your store of experiences. The memory they draw from you is painful, a humiliation that... No, the memory is gone, devoured forever. The tongues hiss with satisfaction and withdraw. Okay, we'll have to do that next round.
I feel terrible.
We're getting all hobbled here. Eritus is still hobbled. And our last cast-off is hobbled. Alright, what else? I'm not gonna mess with these. I've decided. Although we're going to have to open one of them. Or two of them. If we get through this one and then that one, and then we're good. Either that or the other way. Here and here. I'm going to have him go... with Calistige. That thing shouldn't chase him, it'll just fight this thing. Abykos is fully functional. Can he mess with that? Oh, because he's hobbled, he can barely move.
Why not?
Look at that huge hammer he's got, pretty awesome. Okay, now, take control of the tongues and force them to open the nearest doorway. I'll do 95%. Success. You reach out with your mind, sending your thoughts along the connection you forged with the bloom tongues, seizing control of their chittering voices. They hiss and whine, but gradually fall silent. The sacks blocking the nearest doorway deflate, allowing you to pass. Cool. I guess we should send everyone to this one. You only move that much. Yeah, I don't see it use. I mean, even using these tongue things might. I mean, what if we get a memory from one of them now? You know what? I'll just open this way. We'll meet in the middle. I don't want to get too much attention, but eh. These might be special ones. I don't know. Look, she can only get 65%. But it worked. Cool. And her stat, her effort restored. You extend your consciousness and wrap your mind around the tongues. They thrash and hiss, struggling to wrest themselves free, but you assert control over them. They deflate the sacks that block the nearest door, allowing you access to the next chamber. The tongues are tractable now, but you can feel their seething resentment. Oh, it opened. It opened that. Is this the same? The bloom tongues strain toward you, caressing your flesh. Their voices slip into your mind, seeking a memory to devour. You recall a face, someone who meant a great deal to you once. You can almost recall moments you spent together, but the bloom tongues tear them from your grasp. The face slips away, and it's gone, devoured by the tongues. Not a lot of damage, but still. Oh, what's this? Wait, something... Something appeared. Oh, another Corpuscular Maw. Alright. We're on Tiber. I'm gonna have everyone else go through this central one. And... I'm gonna interact with that other bloom tongue. This Abykoses is strong, huh? Let's see if we get anything from this one. Alright. It's hurting me every time. The tongues worm into your memories, assessing and discarding your experiences like rotten fruit. After what seems like an eternity, they settle on one. A close friendship that you betrayed, was it intentional or accidental? The details slip away, and you realize that you no longer remember. Even the friendship is forgotten. The tongues withdraw, satisfied. Okay, I'm gonna leave that alone. I'm gonna keep her right here, so maybe this thing won't attack her. Kinda facing right in my direction, isn't it? Go, Calistees can go that far. Not necessarily in an instant, she's making her way over there. Alright, attack the Abykoses. That's a good Corpuscular Maw. Very good Corpuscular Maw. And another one. A transdimensional rift tears open and several humans tumble out. Inkpot. Inkpot sounds familiar. It's been a couple weeks since I played. The Great Devourer has called us to the heart. You recognize the shrill voice of Inkpot, the Bloom Cultist. A trespasser and defiler is tormenting our god. Let us punish her, brothers. Oh, brother. Bloom Cultist and Inkpot. I think I'm gonna have to use that Bloom Cluster to get out. really can't go far when we're hobbled like that.
Why, of course.
It's half phased again. And now fully phased. Alright, let's do it. So I can get away from them a little easier, because hobbled like that is going to take me forever to get to the doorway. You close your eyes and focus. The tongues slap at you, hissing, trying to distract you, but your concentration is pure and strong, and they finally submit to your will. A wave of stench passes over you as the fleshy sacks deflate, opening the doorway. I can go that far.
Right.
All right. Shall we touch this thing?
We shall see.
Seems like she's answering my questions. Greasy gray tubes feed a thin, rank fluid into the puckered wall of the heart. An enormous irised muscle contracts and pulses, as if held shut by a godlike act of will. Alright. We can use lore to try to prise the muscles apart. We can use healing or natural. Yeah, natural lore, the same as the other. Try to relax the muscles that hold the sphincter closed. Seems a little kinder, doesn't it? Or we can just do smash and try to pinch off one of the tubes that feed the sphincter. Yeah, that's horrible. Can I change to someone else? No, I can't. She doesn't have anything. Oh, it'll use up all her... I'm gonna leave it alone. To have someone else do it. There's Ink Pot. Oh, he's messing with it. Here comes Bloom Cultist.
I'm at least six times better than I was seconds ago.
Attack! No!
I'm making a scratch.
Attack these things! At least the two others are occupied.
I must find a way to shake this off.
Bloom Quake, that's what it was. Okay, is he any good with this?
Sure enough.
He can't do anything.
At last.
I actually just want to leave without even... yeah. That would be me then. Spatial crash. Crash or clash?
I'm ready.
See if I can do any healing. Oh, I can't. I have to wait. Damn it. Where's the thing? Abykoses? Are they gonna attack us now? If everyone attacks us, that would not be good. Don't I? Wait a second. Negates the effects of Esoteria's ranged attacks. Immediately remove all positive and status fetals from all enemies. Okay, I want to take our fetals away. Hmm. Consumes movement. What if I use this? Plus 45% on non-combat tasks. Do it.
Perfect.
What makes a difference?
As you wish.
We could still only get to 55%. Damn it. Failure. You push and pull on the muscles, but you don't manage to find any kind of pressure point that will relieve the contraction. That's... Oh, wait. Ugh. At least a human, the other human, fought the Abykoses for some reason. Oh, now the Maw's on us. Good, you attack Abykoses. Well, Abykoses is messed up. Here's another Maw. Gotta get the hell out of here. Ugh. We got a Bloom Quake. That's what it is. What does Tiber have? Deals transdimensional damage. Swap positions. What's this? Might as well attack it, I guess.
Barely making a scratch.
No, we got it down more than half.
Alright.
Oh, it transferred him over there. That's no good. Well, we got rid of one foe. You know what?
I could stand a little more of that.
A little bit more. Oh, that's my turn. I'm over there.
Let's go.
Ah, damn it. I still can't do anything. We're gonna have to smash this thing open. What is this? Might as well use this. She got plus one intelligence as well. Don't think that's gonna help with this though. Nope, she can't even take an action. Or cast stasis on it.
Barely making a stretch.
Well, that's because you weren't attacking, he was.
I need to shake this.
Myalgic dust? Oh, there's more than one Bloom Cultist. We need to leave.
Barely making a stretch.
Well, that's a good thing. Yeah, we need to get the hell out of here. There's another one.
What's happening to me?
Oh. we got an attack of opportunity or some crap. Ah, I can't even go. Pass. Waiting to move, take an opportunity with this thing. She can get to 100%. Cool, my stat pool's restored. From your sire's memories of anatomy, you know that physiological structures like this generally do not have antagonistic muscles to oppose their movement. Thus, it will remain in a state of tonic contraction until you find a way to relax its hold. You get to work massaging the muscles, and you see some of the tension ease from them. The contraction slackens. Unfortunately, it's not enough. You'll have to further weaken the sphincter before it will open. Good God.
What's happening to me?
That's some kind of critical hit.
Ready.
Yeah, that's stupid. Cut it open. Try to pry. Okay, so that was a failed effort. We shouldn't even try that. Pinch off one of the things. I don't want to wait a full round to get back to the transdimensional scalpel. I'll have someone else try one of the other things. We tried to do it the nice way, right? Pretty much okay for the moment. Calistige. I don't think smashing is... No, she doesn't have any might. Right, this is might. 30%. Same, okay. I'm gonna attack these guys then. What does she have that is good? They're using flash on us a lot. Negates the effects of esoteries and ranged attacks. But they also... They have weapons. Although these guys... I'm gonna use that. Because I don't know what else. This is, intellect pool. Yeah. Gonna use it. I mean, I could have her use a spell, but just it's not gonna kill everyone. It's probably not gonna kill anyone. Now, is it just on her or on all of us? I guess just on her. Well, she can also still attack. Maelstrom, no. If we can attack, go for it.
World is this?
Which world is this? Did someone die? No, I don't think so. I'm supposed to cancel the... I guess just on her.
A stretch.
We're getting messed up here. Who's that? Calistes? Get out of there.
Barely making a stretch.
Okay, Eritus. Smash this open. Oh, it's Tiber. 70%. New! Failed! You stand atop a tube, pinching it tight, but the pumping action is too strong. A sudden surge knocks you off balance, and you stagger off the tube. Oh, damn it. Can I try again?
Why not?
Nope. And I can't even attack this round. Damn it. Hold on. I'm not discarding. Yeah, he needs a little help.
I can stand a little more of that.
Nerytus was the most hurt. Okay. I hope so. God damn, open. You stand atop one of the vents, or veins, sorry, pinching it tight. The walls of the tube flex and strain, and you press down harder just as another surge forces more bloom juice through it. The elastic skin of the tube tears, and yellowish fluid sprays out.
Ugh.
Unfortunately, it's not enough. You will have to further weaken the sphincter before it will open. God damn. We need lore natural. We have to do all three, I guess. And he can't attack this time. Pass.
Barely making a scratch.
Can't say I mind that.
Yeah, I kind of mind it.
On it.
Well, that's me. Okay. Cut it open, though, to trans-dimensional scalpel. You slide the scalpel across the muscles that protect the heart, and they separate and fall away. Noxious fluid sprays from the wound, and the subsonic pulsing of the heart begins to race, as if in panic or fury. You carve a space large enough to crawl through.
Something new.
Something new is wrong with me.
I'm going.
Party scattered. We need her. She got scattered. Calistige. Speaking of who? You can't hit it?
Yes.
Excuse me, pardon me. Ink pot. Another flash for the road.
Barely making a scratch. Barely making a scratch.
He keeps saying that. He's not attacking. Yeah, he is making a scratch.
Barely making a scratch.
They all want to attack Calistige.
Barely making a scratch.
God damn, let's go.
Making a scratch.
Oh god. Okay. Let's go. Come on, we can't. Retreat? I'm clicking it. I'm clicking. You've got to be freaking kidding me. It's not letting him go. Damn it. We have to kill all them first? Well, that's a good idea. This one. Completely refills the health of both target and caster. You'll switch spots with Calistige. Since they're all attacking her. Alright. There you go. Oh, and we can attack as well? Sweet.
Down you go.
Can we go? Please? Why couldn't Tyvir go? Was he blocked? Was there someone in front of him? Oh no, at least we're out of there. Holy crap. Into the depths. We're into the heart interior. Take control of the Bloom's heart and command it to release Ishin. If the heart is anything like the Bloom's maws and tongues, I should be able to establish a mental link and seize control of it. Then I can command it to release the Memoviria's missing scholar Ishin. And what's this one again? Covetous hearts? Yeah, this quest should not even been here. We gave him the cortex, and he let us keep the magmatic annulet. So, made it through there. I guess this is a good time to cut it off. A little bit of a longer episode, but I'm not going to cut off. Ew, sphincter. I'm not going to cut it off in the middle of that huge battle and all that. Is that energy? Or is that like matter, like food? Digesting. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.